interview with the vocalist of Thy Will Be Done on July 25th, 2009. The name of the band, Thy Will Be Done, is interesting to say the least, and sounds as if there's a story behind it. Where did the name come from, and what is the story?
There's a lot of reasons for it. We've gone through a lot of lineup changes, and the music was just getting a little bit more epic, a little bit more heavy. And when it came time, we had a lot of names that we had put down on some paper. One of the names that was down was one I had put down was Thy Will Be Done. And it just kind of reminds you like the old days, like they had the Test and Exodus. Those names are just so timeless and just so powerful. Obviously, people know of the other connotation of it, so which is, obviously.
Kind of all came together real quickly, right when we got back from Japan, we just got back
maybe in a 5 or 6 hour position in this room that we got from rehearsal building that we practiced in. The landlord let us borrow this room. Didn't charge us for it. Let's just shoot away. And it was about, I'd say 100 degrees in that room. It was just terrible. And then we just had a couple ideas, and then the director really just took it from there and did his editing magic. So.
Many of your songs are so hard and intense that I am sure they translate well into a live setting. Taking on a whole new life in front of a live audience, how does it make you feel when the emotion and power that you envisioned in the recording studio comes to life when playing in front of a crowd?
I love it. Actually, I live for playing live. It's one of my favorite things. That those 30 minutes or 20 minutes on this tour that you get on stage makes everything else worth it. All the headaches, the traffic, the driving, the parking, sometimes just little things, they get to you. It just makes you forget about it. When you're up on that stage, and you get that emotion into it. You do it for the right reasons, in my opinion. That's why we're doing it. We love it. It's just so rewarding.
Cool. What are the upcoming plans for you guys?
Well, we're doing the Splash and Burn tour right now with Devil Driver and the other amazing bands. After this, we actually go to Europe for weeks. We'll go there with Earth Crisis and Sworn Enemy. And then that takes us to the end of September, early October, when we get home. We're doing the CD release show with Hatebreed. And then from there on, we kind of have an open schedule. Nothing really solidified yet. I'm hoping we can fill that schedule in pretty soon and do some stuff. That's the goal.
Cool. How has MySpace and the internet impacted your band? And do you think downloading helps or hurts the artist?
I think double-edged sword. I'm always one for people. If they want to download music and pay for it, I'm all about it. So downloading for free and keeping a record if you like it and not going out and buying it, it's basically you're hurting that band, because if you're not selling the records, the label's not making any money, and now that band they're not an asset for that label, and now all of a sudden they get dropped from the label, they're not getting tours. Poor sales numbers, you're not going to get on big tours. So now people need to find out about the band. So people who really love the band, go buy it. But the internet has helped. I won't get into that real quick. But MySpace has been great. To me, I like to use it in a sense where I can communicate with people and talk with people. And I try, it takes a lot longer sometimes because we don't always have internet access on the road. But I do personally try and get in touch with everybody who writes us. And it takes a long time, but I've been trying my best.
What is the toughest lesson you've ever learned in the studio and on the stage?
That I'm human. And that nothing is going to go exactly as planned. Lessons we've learned, I think, would be that no matter what, we have to constantly remind ourselves why we do what we do, because we love it.
What bands would you like to tour with, and what has been your favorite to tour with so far?
I'll tell you what, it's an honor right now that we're on the road with Devil Driver. I'm excited. But definitely, if I could say any bands or any artists, just because I can represent all of them, the entire band, when I say this, we could tour with Black Sabbath, with Ozzy, that'd be amazing. Metallica, oh my gosh, Metallica number one for all of us could probably be. That'd be amazing. Maybe a reunited Temple tour. That'd be pretty amazing. And there's so many. Oh, it's so difficult to say. Sheehan, that'd be awesome. We did a show with Sheehan, which I think that was great. With Tim and Rob Flynn, and how we talk. It's great. But man, I can't pick one. I don't know. Two. There's a few.
Every band has its mutual influences. What are some of the other bands and artists that have greatly influenced you guys in the
band? We are a very eclectic band. We listen to everything from rock to Bach, industrial to, everything. To even classical guitar, I guess, flamenco. I mean, we listen to everything. I don't know. The influence is everything from Black Sabbath to early Metallica. Slayer, Testament, Misfits, us. It's really hard to say. I mean, you know, like, death and suffocation to death and death. And even like the Allman Brothers, Tool, we're like all over the place. We're really all over, like, honestly. To even like Corrosion of Conformity, Crowbar, and on us, Pantera.
Meaningful statement such as, "You're going to change my life," has it ever happened?
Has it just happened? Okay.